guys. So you know the other day when I went to my math class where I had to teach, how to teach other teachers? Remember? We were talking about something really, really cool. And I wanted to try it with you to see if you could help me solve a problem. Do you think you can help me solve a problem? How many brownies do I have here on the table, Madison?
Six.
All right, can we count them together?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Well, six brownies look delicious.
I didn't look at there.
Oh, and how many kids do we have at the table? How many kids do we have at the table, Ashley?
Four.
Let's count to each other. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Six brownies and four kids. How can we share these brownies so that everyone gets a fair and equal amount? What do you think? You think everyone should have two brownies? Okay, should we try it out? All right, I'll touch it because I know your hands are clean too, but I'll touch and see. Ready? All right, so let's give Caitlin two. Should we try it? 1, 2 for Caitlin. Let's give Madison two. Ready? 1, 2 for Madison. Let's give Draven two. 1, 2 for Draven. Uh-oh. Is there a problem?
Yes, Ashley.
Ashley doesn't have any. So it has to be what? More than two or less than two?
Less than two.
Less than two. So let's put it back then. Let's try again. It can't be two. What do you think we can do? How can we split it? You think one, Draven?
Oh.
All right, let's see if one works. Okay. Let's give one to Caitlin. Let's give one right there to Madison. Let's give one to Draven and one to Ashley.
And one for you.
Does that work?
But what about for you?
Oh, so we have two left over, but I'm not going to eat one.
Why?
Because it's only the kids at the table. So does it work that we can give each other one brownie? But then we have, go ahead and put that back. But now we have two left over. Can we still share this?
Yeah.
What can we do to share this? Caitlin, what do you think?
Carve it into halves.
Carve it into halves. What does that mean?
To cut it.
Or you can cut it? Like you carve a pumpkin.
Can you show me? Don't cut it all the way, but can you show me what cutting it into halves looks like? Oh, okay. So go ahead and try it. Can you try to cut it?
Oh! I got another one.
All right. Do you think you can cut it into half also? Show me. Whoa. So what does that mean to cut it into half?
Pieces.
Into pieces? Like how many pieces?
Four.
Into how many pieces?
Four.
Is it four pieces? Did we cut this into four pieces?
Hey, you're not supposed to eat that yet.
Hold on. I have a question because Caitlin asked me something. Ashley just told me something. Ashley said that cutting things into halves is cutting into pieces.
And it made smaller.
Does it? Hold on. Don't.
It works.
It. Oh, hold on. I heard what you just said. You said it works because we made four, but just don't eat it yet, okay? 1 second. I had a quick question for you, though. You said cutting it in half means to cutting into pieces. How many pieces does that mean that we're cutting it into if we're cutting it into half? Tell me.
Four.
You think four. What do you think, Caitlin?
Four.
You think four. What do you think? Four. And what about you?
Four.
Four. Now, why do you think four?
Because it is four.
Because what? But did we cut this in half?
Yes.
If I cut this in half, how many pieces do I have?
Four.
I cut this in half, right? Did I cut this in half? How many pieces do I have?
Four.
Right here.
Two.
Two. And I cut this in half, right? How many pieces do I have?
Two.
Two pieces. So when you cut something in half, what are you cutting it into? How many pieces?
Four.
Two pieces. So we're cutting things into two pieces. Does this work? Wait. Does this work? We have one, 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 one. And now, who do I give this to? Draven. Okay, don't touch yet. Who do I give this to?
Caitlin.
Who do I give this to?
Ashley.
And this one to Madison. So, if I had six, oh, I heard what you said, that that's fair. So if I cut six brownies up and I have to give it to four people, how much does each person get? How much does each person get?
Two.
You get two pieces? Yes. But how much is the two of the same pieces? Are they the same size?
This is like math.
This is like math. I didn't even notice that. Wow, are we doing math when we're eating our treats? We are. So tell me, we have two pieces, but are they the same size? Okay, go sit down, please.
You didn't know? No.
They're not the same size, right?
It is, man.
One is bigger and one is smaller. This is half of that big piece, yes? So how many do we have? We have one and a half, right? Two pieces or one and a half brownies. Aren't they delicious looking? Oh, put it together and make three. Why would you make three if you put it together? Tell me why you would make it three. Go ahead. If you cut this in half, let's try it. Because cutting it in half means cutting it into how many pieces? Cutting in half means cutting it into how many pieces?
Three.
How many pieces did I cut?
Two
pieces. So how much does Draven have? How many pieces does he have? Three equal pieces. Or, you know what I can call it? I can tell you, but I think I want you to try to figure it out.
Three halves.
Good. So you each have, let's see, one, two, three halves. Nice job. Now, do you think if you ate three halves, it would be healthy for you?
Yes.
Oh, that'll give you a bellyache. So what I'm going to allow you to do is take one half, and we're going to save the rest.
Yesterday I had daisies and we ate cake and we had junk food.
Wow. Thank you, boys and girls, for trying to help me solve this problem. So now can I split?
Oh my God, he's eating it.
I know, I told you can have half. Can I split brownies with four people if I have six brownies evenly? So that everyone has a fair amount? Yeah, we can. We can have three halves. Thank you. Go ahead.
But there's 12.
Well, now there are 12, right?